Welcome back to stage two of this demo series. In this stage, you're going to be configuring the Google Identity Provider. This means you'll be creating a Google API project and some credentials which the serverless application can use to interact with the Google IDP. Using this, the application can direct sessions at the Google IDP for authentication, which will return the Google authentication token if this process is successful. By the end of this stage, you'll have this running, but, and it's crucial to keep this in mind constantly, this token cannot be used to interact with AWS resources. That's what you're going to be fixing in stage three. So let's get started implementing this. And for that, we're going to need to move back to our desktop. Now, at this point, I would recommend using the text-based instructions for this demo series, and this is linked to every video for this demo series. So go ahead and open that now. And the first thing that we need to do is to create a Google API project. Any application which uses OAuth 2.0 to access the Google APIs must have authorization credentials that identify that specific application to Google's OAuth 2.0 server. So our serverless application will be using Google for authentication, and so we need a way to identify our application to Google, and that's what we're going to do next. Now, in order to do this, you're going to need a Google login. Now, Gmail is fine, so you can either use your existing Gmail credentials or you can create a specific brand new Google account. Both of those will work fine. But the first step is to move to the Google API console. Now, the link for this is attached to this lesson and included in the text instructions. If you're not already logged in, you'll be prompted to sign in using your Google ID. And if you don't have an account, you can go ahead and create one by clicking Create Account. In my case, I'll be using one of my existing Google accounts, so I'll go ahead and sign in. Once you're logged in, you'll see the Google APIs console. And the first thing we'll need to do is to create a new project representing our application. So click on the Select a Project drop-down. You probably won't have any projects at this point, so you'll need to go ahead and click on New Project. Now, you might be provided with a random name for your project, but go ahead and replace this, and I suggest you call this Pet IDF for Pet ID Federation. Now, it won't call your project what you put in this box. It will instead give you a random project ID. That's fine. We're just going to refer to this as Pet IDF. So once you've entered that, go ahead and click on Create. Now, this might take a few moments to finish creating, and we just need to wait for that to complete. Once that has finished, we need to go ahead and click on Configure Consent Screen. So this is where we configure various different permissions and access rights of our application. The first thing we need to select is whether this application that we're using is only catering to internal users, so that's users of your G Suite organization, or if you're making this accessible to external users, so any user with a Google account. And that's what we're going to do. So select External and then click on Create. We want this application to be available to everybody in the world because it's that important. Now, again, we'll need to provide an application name, so go ahead and enter Pet IDF in the app name box, and then you'll need to click in the user support email dropdown and select your Gmail ID. So go ahead and select that, and then scroll down, and we don't need to enter anything into any of these boxes except the developer contact information. And in here, you'll need to enter your email address. So go ahead and do that. Once that's entered, click on Save and Continue. We don't need to make any changes on the scope screen, so scroll down to the bottom and click Save and Continue. We don't need to enter anything on the test user screen, so again, just go ahead and click on Save and Continue. And then on the summary screen, we can scroll all the way down to the bottom and just click on Back to Dashboard. And that's the consent screen, which has been configured. Now that we've configured that, click on Credentials on the menu on the left. And this is where we're creating the API credentials that our serverless application will use to communicate with the Google Identity Provider. So to do that, we need to click on Create Credentials, and it's going to be an OAuth-based application. So we need to click on OAuth Client ID. Now, the application type that we're creating together is a web application. So go ahead and click in the dropdown and select Web Application. Under Name, go ahead and replace the placeholder with Pet IDF Serverless App. And then we're going to scroll down, and then also on this screen, we need to make one other change. We need to add an authorized JavaScript origin. Now, this serverless application is running from the app bucket, but it's fronted by CloudFront to provide HTTPS capability. So we need to enter the domain name associated with the CloudFront distribution into this authorized JavaScript origins box. So go ahead and click Add URI, and then we need to move back to the CloudFront console, open up this distribution, and then copy the CloudFront distribution domain name into our clipboard, return back to this API tab, and paste this into this box. And once you've entered that, scroll all the way down to the bottom and just click on Create. Now, once this is created, you'll be presented with two pieces of information. You'll have your client ID and your client secret. Now, we'll be using the client ID later in this demo series, so go ahead and copy that into your clipboard and note it down somewhere safe, but you won't be using the client secret. So while I have hidden this on my screen, you don't need to worry about it, you won't be using it. So make sure you've got a note of your client ID, and then just go ahead and click on OK. Now that's everything that you need to do in stage 2 of this demo series. So at this point, we have the front-end application bucket, we have the private patches S3 bucket with the sensitive cat images, and we've configured a Google API project as well as credentials for that project, which our serverless application will use to interact with the Google APIs. So that's everything required for stage 2. By this point, if we configured the serverless application files in the front-end bucket, then our users could use the serverless application to authenticate with the Google identity provider and get back a Google Auth token. But we can't use this to interact with AWS. That's what we're going to configure in the next stage, stage 3 of this demo series. So go ahead and complete this video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next stage.